Kim Kardashian says she takes Beyond Meat wherever she travels. Hey Kim, I got some Beyond Meat in my pants if you want to take me with you wherever you travel. And you know what's actually disgusting about this? I bet these psychopathic Beyond Meat moron CEOs spent tons of marketing revenue on this because their stock took a royal shit over the past 2 weeks. I mean, the general population is pretty naive, and you might think they are foolish enough to buy this, but I think this YouTube skit they did is a bit too forced.
Don't mind us pushers. We're gonna push ourselves to the gym after this. Hey guys, it's Kim
and Tracy,
and we are so excited to be a part of Push Your Wellness.
I don't think that people realize, but Kim is an amazing, amazing cook. Every single time I come to her home, the number one thing that I ask for you to make is always these tacos.
So how I do that is with the Beyond.
I mean, this is like the fakest 20 seconds of any video you could ever manufacture. Every time I go to your house, I always ask you to make these tacos. It's so ridiculous. It's so
Meat from
ridiculous.
Beyond Meat, and I write down my recipe.
I mean, what's even more ridiculous is the mise en place. Like, they had some poor guy chopping fruits and vegetables and all this nonsense for 5 hours straight, and that perfectly typed recipe. Okay.
Recipe so that whoever's cooking it comes into my house and I want the tacos, I always write it down. And we start off with getting 1 tablespoon of avocado oil.
Perfect.
And you just pour it in the pan.
Easy enough.
And then here you take the 2 pounds of the Beyond Meat plant-based ground beef. And it cooks like just like ground beef.
It really does.
The thing that I really love about Beyond Meat is it has zero cholesterol.
How much did they get paid to do this? Like, they're reading directly from the script. They're not enthusiastic about it. This has got to be a joke.
It's like crazy.
Oh my gosh.
In comparison to, you know, real meat, and it has a third less of the saturated fat. So there is a big difference.
Okay, if I eat this, will my voice get deeper? Because I feel a little bit emasculated as the voices of you two lovely ladies seem a few octaves deeper than my own.
Just a plant-based alternative to meat that looks like meat, tastes like meat. I'm such a fan. So once you get this going, you will add
I'm such
two
a fan.
Tablespoons of cumin, 2 tablespoons of chili powder, 1 tablespoon of the...
Okay, the meat tastes so good. We got to add 15 spices to it because of how good the meat tastes on its own. It clearly tastes just like ground beef.
Garlic salt, 1 onion powder, tablespoon of onion powder, and 1.5 teaspoons of oregano, 1 teaspoon of kosher salt, 1/4 teaspoon.
I was
of
joking
ground
about
pepper.
The number 15, but it
so
looks like we're getting
we're
close.
Done seasoning it all. Do I just stir? I just stir it all together. Get the seasoning all over the
yes.
Beyond.
Just kind of like mix it all around.
Got it. Okay, so
once it's like really seasoned and it has everything and it just like looks.
You're ready to Beyond barf.
Like it's all cooked together. We're gonna add 1/4 cup of water, 2 tablespoons of organic ketchup, and 2 tablespoons of agave.
Oh, good thing the ketchup's organic.
Okay. Kim, I'm so excited. I'm gonna be able to make this at home now.
I know, it's so easy.
So easy, but it smells so good.
So I just put a little bit of the avocado oil on the pan. Take the tortillas, and these tortillas are gluten-free, but not taste-free. That is a myth.
How did this start? Like, what made you decide to, you know, make that lifestyle change to going plant-based?
I think I watched a documentary on it. I did it not religiously, only when I was at home. And I just met chefs that love to cook plant-based and were teaching me so much about like sea moss and all of this like amazing food that...
You can't make this stuff up. She brings up sea moss. This is so ridiculous. Look at her hair. She looks like some type of devil or some type of goat with that. Oh my god.
Have these really good health benefits. So I would always say like I'm plant-based when I'm at home, but I'm not plant-based if I go to a restaurant. Like I can't control myself.
Yeah.
Oh, so you're plant-based where people can't film you, but coincidentally when people can see what you're eating, you're not plant-based. Oh, that sounds That sounds right.
Stopped, I got over it. Or maybe a year later, I got reintroduced to it. I think I tried something that was just really good and it was plant-based. I luckily have the help of amazing chefs that have figured out how to find the things that I really love and to make a plant-based version of that. I never want to be a hypocrite and say, like, if I do go out and want fish like once a month, yeah, then I'll have that.
I was gonna say, it's gotta be so hard when you're traveling with the kids. Yeah. And I know you also travel with your Beyond Meat.
Oh, I'll literally...
I can't imagine writing that script. I know you also travel with your Beyond Meat. Yes, I too travel with my Beyond Meat when I meet all the lovely ladies.
Bring like a container of food that I can bring the meat and start cooking it myself.
We did go on vacation.
Like TSA is searching her Gucci or Versace, her like $29,000 purse, and there's a package of Beyond Meat in it.
Recently, and I will say, like, the breakfast bar that Kim had set up, you know, with her chefs was just like, you had like the Beyond sausage and the Beyond.
And no one knew the difference. Yeah, everyone was gravitating. Even that night, everyone thought it was fried chicken and it was really mushrooms.
Yeah. Which, by the
way, oh, these people.
The way I actually preferred those fried mushrooms over the actual fried chicken. They're so good.
Yeah.
And this is so easy and quick.
Just heating up the tortillas. I put a little bit of avocado oil and then I just put them in the pan.
Using a lot of avocado oil. We did a video touching on avocado. We mentioned the avocado oil. It's definitely not the best oil. It's not the end of the world. Avoid it for the most part.
It's a nice little trick because before I normally actually, I warm up my tortillas in the oven while I'm cooking, but this is actually, this gives it a nice crispiness that I probably wouldn't be able to get if I'm just doing it in the oven.
Okay, you want me to make you the first one?
Yes.
So we fill it. And then I put a little bit of the sour cream.
Vegan cheese and sour cream, I've tried them in past vegan tasting videos. Absolutely disgusting. You're better off just putting like onions and mushrooms on there because the fake sour cream, the fake cheese actually tastes worse than just the plain Beyond bullshit itself. It's like gym socks.
There.
Oh, and a little cilantro
that is the
too.
Kim K's vegan tacos.
Don't say it. Don't say it tastes like gym socks and rotten nuts to the vegan boys though. That gets them excited.
Oh my God, Kim.
It's so good, right?
So good.
By the way, I always get rid of my first tortilla.
Why?
Because it always gets too oily. Mm.
Wow, and these tortillas actually don't taste like they're
any different, right?
No, you can't tell. And do the kids love these tacos?
They do. I try to get them to eat as much plant-based as possible. They really don't know the difference.
Maybe North might feel
they really don't know the difference.
Like she's very...
She'd be into it.
Yeah.
Why don't you give a pile of Beyond bullshit to a baby and then a pile of ground beef to a baby and see which one they eat. Yeah, they don't know the difference.
Yeah,
let the child choose based on its instincts.
I will say, I used to not like fake cheese until I had it here. Mm-hmm. Because I feel like
it's still not like obvious.
Liar.
The meat is
liar. I mean, they're lying the whole video, but
I prefer this meat.
I prefer this meat over regular meat.
Me too.
I
so these are
take
almond
this.
Flour tortillas.
Yes, they're better to me than regular.
They are, I agree.
Oh, get them, I'm done. Look, there's 20 seconds left in this video. I'm not watching the rest of it because my brain's gonna explode. I'll do it for you guys.
I eat like this every day. I would switch to plant-based too because you don't feel like you're missing anything. I don't feel like I'm compromising in the flavor and the texture. Everything is so delicious.
How do you know that you took half a bite of the fucking taco, lady?
And you guys can get this recipe for Kim K's famous vegan tacos on poosh.com. I can't wait to see pictures. You guys have...
Great, me too. I'll take a picture. And the people in the comments of this top one, 7,000 likes. I'm convinced Kim's never cooked this before. She's reading the directions like this is the first time she's made it. And people are hysterical. Like, I just wrote to say the same thing. The lies in this video are just hilarious. So people think this is bullshit too. And I'm surprised this comment wasn't deleted, to be honest. But if you guys have missed the past videos we've done on Beyond Meat, you know, we went in depth on this, super in depth. We went over all the ingredients, how they're marketing such nonsense. You go on their website, they have nice pictures of the whole food. They don't show you the powder chemicals that are actually being added to this. When you look at the ingredient list, it's not like, oh, look at all those nice ingredients they're putting in. No, water, pea protein isolate, expeller pressed canola oil, refined coconut oil, rice protein, natural flavors. It's a bunch of powders and liquids. They're mashing together. Overall, it's high in omega-6. It's inflammatory. It's high in anti-nutrients, chemicals. It is not good for you. It's too many ingredients. So definitely search Frank Tufano Beyond Meat on my channel if you want a really in-depth explanation on why Beyond Meat is bad for you. But I have a feeling they're gonna do some supply chain bullshit, say the animals got sick, pull some stunt to force people to eat this, jack up the price. I mean, who knows what's going to happen? Because this propaganda, this ridiculous stuff, it's not working for most people, but we'll see how this pans out. It's happening very, very, very soon, and I'm scared because all of the carnivores, ooh-wee, are on the same side as the vegan fairy boys to mislead you into consuming estrogenic crap. I heard a term earlier, it was like the globo homo. Like for the term for like the leaders in charge, like the globo homo. I thought it was hilarious, but I won't get too much into that. So thank you guys for joining me. If you can please drop a like on the video, leave a comment down below, subscribe so that YouTube can unsubscribe you next week, and make sure to check that notification bell so they don't notify you of my videos. And for any of you saying like, oh Frank, the reason they took away a few thousand of your subscribers is because you called a girl a thotty, or could you make fun of gay people? No, look, the way gay guys are, they are so infatuated with me, they don't even understand what I'm saying. They're just staring at me the whole video. So let's be very clear about that. It's a fluke.